we see now a row of activities with a fascist atmosphere against anybody who is not a right-wing supporter of the settlements, of the big Israel, of the Jewish state. It seems that for some years now, for at least 3 years, there is an organization that recently called itself Ad Kan, that tries to plant people, infiltrators in different human rights organizations. It seems that for the last 3 years, people were planted in different organizations, different activities, different demonstrations in Bilin, in Alin, all over. But they could not bring raw material that would serve anyone. They could not incriminate those organizations. And then they changed the tactics and they brought a couple, a woman and a man, Yulia and Itzik, and planted them in the Ta'ayush organization. It's very easy to do so. You just have to get to the Facebook of different organizations and you just have to join a demonstration. And as they say, they are welcoming, the leftists are welcoming every person who comes. This couple that I just mentioned were planted about a year and 3 or 4 months ago to the organization. But their tactics was not just to participate in the public activities, but really to acquire the heart of Ezra Nawi, who is one of the leaders of the organization. So they tried, as they say, to isolate him with them from the others, to be in an intimate situations with him, and in order to achieve something. In one of the so many hours that he had together with that infiltrator, Itzik, he talked about himself and his activities and how he hates those who sell Palestinian land. We know that such selling and buying of Palestinian land is usually followed by forgery, by people who make up themselves, by bribery. Everything is stinking in these cases. And when Ezra said, quite innocently, to whom he believed was his friend in such a conversation, he said, those people, whenever I meet anyone, I give him to the Palestinian Authority, so and then he's been tortured and killed, etc. He said so. I believe that the Ad Kan organization who sent those two infiltrators said, wow, this is an opportunity. Now we can nail him. And about a month later, they sent someone to call Ezra. So someone calls and pretends to be a land merchant, a Palestinian. He understood that there is a trap here. Automatically, he talked to Guy Butavia, who is another activist, and say, hey, can you check anything about that person? And then Guy said, couldn't find any information about him. Ezra is now more aware of what's going on. So yes, he tries to pass the information to people who own that same piece of land that that person is offering. And then he goes to Nasser Nawaja and says, there is this person who wants to sell me land that part of it belongs to your family. I must tell you that the arrest took place a year and a few months later. It didn't happen right away.